in the Methodist Seminary in Tennessee. He found a copy of the Quran, and while he was going through the seminary, seminary is the school you go to become a priest or a preacher. And he found a copy of the Quran, he read it, he said, this is the truth, and he made shahada and he became Muslim. After I became Muslim, I met another Catholic priest from Africa who had accepted Islam, and he took the name Omar. And he was one of the shining stars of Islam in Richardson, Texas. He was so sweet and so active. And then I met an archbishop from the Orthodox, Russian Orthodox Church, who accepted Islam in New York, and then he came to Texas. And he told a similar story about coming to Islam that all of us do, that you're trying to get close to Allah, to the Lord, and then finally, you try to worship Him the same way Jesus did. And mentioning the verses from the Bible that say, worship, that He's telling the people, my God and your God, my Lord and your Lord. And whenever you try to worship the God of Jesus, the Lord of Jesus, the way that Jesus worshiped the Lord, which was to pray to Him direct with nobody in between. And Allah says, Man alladhi yashfa'u indahu illa bi'idhnih. Who can do any intercession unless Allah gives a permission anyway? And when you pray direct to Him, then comes the guidance of Allah. And then finally, I want to mention something to you in closing this little session today. It's not a little session, it's kind of big one. But I want to mention this to you. That, as the brothers actually we were sitting talking about last night, they reminded me about a hadith of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Muhammad, peace and blessing be upon him, mentioned that if anybody asks from God, that God will give it to them. Ask and you'll receive it. If anybody is seeking after something, then Allah, He will give them what they're looking for. Remember we were talking about that, Tawfiq, remember? Yes. And then, it says knock, right? I think you were the one talking about it, weren't you?
Dr. Ashraf.
They said it, knock, and it will be opened. I have to tell you something. I was sitting with a scholar from Egypt one time, and he was giving explanation of Quran, and we were sitting there. I love to sit with the ulama of Islam, just sit there in the masjid and listen to them explain things. It's so beautiful. And he was saying, you know, that the Quran is nothing more than what Allah sent down before, except one verse. The Prophet ﷺ said, Allah revealed a verse in the Quran, which He never revealed in any previous scripture. And that ayah, that verse, is in Surah Fatiha. That verse is, Ihdina Siratal Mustaqim. Guide us to the straight path. What's so amazing about that? What's amazing about this verse? But when he said that, it hit me and it hit me and it hit me. I kept thinking. This must be an amazing thing, or Allah would not preserve a saying like that for 1400 years for me to hear it, would He? What's amazing about this? It's something amazing. Let me go through and I want to see. I have a concordance of the Bible in the English and I can check it in the Greek dictionary. I can check it in the Hebrew dictionary and I'll find, did He ever use such a term as this about guidance? Let me see. And I could not find anything like it exactly. But I did find the exact words of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the Bible about seek and you'll find, and ask and it will be given to you, and knock and it will be opened. Knock on what? I can understand seeking and finding and asking and receiving, but knocking, what's this? What is this parable about knocking, and opening, knocking on the heart, knock that heart into shape, knock on that heart, and then it will be open, and it will be, what will be open? What is the name of the first surah in the Quran? Al-Fatiha. What does that mean in English? The opening. Oh my God. There it is, it opens up. And there it is. And it's A'udhu Billahi Minash Shaitani Rajeem. Bismillahir Rahmanir Raheem. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Ar-Rahmanir Raheem. Maliki Yawmiddin. Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'een. Ihdina siratal mustaqeem. صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. What is this? This is the seven oft-repeated verses. This is the opening chapter of the Quran. This is what the Muslim reads in his prayer, in his worship, five times a day, every day, all of his life. This is the foundation of the prayers, without which your prayer is not complete. Not complete. Deficient. As the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said. What does it mean? In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful. All praise is due to Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful, the ruler, the Lord, the sovereign on the day of judgment. You only do we worship, and you only do we turn to for guidance. Guide us on the straight path, the path of those who have your favor, your nama, not the path of those who have your anger, nor those who go astray, misguided. Amen. Alhamdulillah, the praise is only to Allah. And guidance is only from above. And what I just said to you is actually in the Bible. And I call all of those who follow the book of Moses, the Jews, and the book of Jesus, the Gospel, the Torah and the Injil. I call them to read their book and think what Allah said. And I call them to reflect on these words. And I call them to worship God alone without any partners. As it's mentioned in their own book as the first commandment. In the book of Exodus, chapter 20. And the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 6. Clearly stating, thou shalt have no other gods beside God. Reflect on this. Think about this. Let Allah be your guide. Let Almighty God guide you as He guided me, as He guided Father Peter Jacobs, as He guided my father, and He guided Imam Siraj Wahaj, who used to be a minister for the Nation of Islam, and as He guided Ali bin Hatim and Abdul bin Salam and Salman al-Farsi. As He guided all the people, ask for guidance from the One above. And if your heart's clean and sincere, then there's no doubt in my mind you'll be guided aright. But if there's something wrong with that heart, you're never going to make it. Because as Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, there's a morsel of flesh in every body, in every person. That if that morsel of flesh is good, then the whole of the matter is good. But if it's bad, then the whole of the matter is corrupt, is rotten. And that morsel of flesh is the heart. And my friend that brought me to Islam told me one time that there is a part of the human being that is the heart. You must never scratch the dignity of a person. Don't hurt their heart. And there's nothing more loved by Allah than the heart of a Muslim. So may Allah make us of those people who submit to Him, surrender to Him, obey Him in sincerity with our hearts. And may He guide us and guide all the people to the truth. Amen. Now, Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, you have been listening to Islam Tomorrow. You visit us on the internet at www.islamtomorrow.com. Until next time, this is Sheikh Estes. Reminding you that Allah is the guide of Hayy. Call on Him and He'll answer your prayers. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.